How far have we got left?
Oh my gosh, I don't know. 2 miles? 1 mile?
2.3 miles-ish.
Alright.
Running right by the river. Look at her, go.
Like, I started running just casually when I was in junior high. And then when I got into high school, I joined the cross country team and just kind of fell in love with running and like was quickly kind of went to the top and was like getting really fast and really good. And then all of a sudden my health just kind of like started to decline. There was the chronic headaches. There was just the chronic fatigue, just not feeling good all the time. Like I grew up in like a very workhorse type of family. Like my dad is a rancher and I have ranching on both sides of my family. And it's all like, you can't be sick. You can't sleep in, you can't rest. Like you need to just go, go, go. Like illness is weakness. And even when I lived with my dad, when I was like 13, 14, anytime I felt sick, it was like, you can't be sick, like get up, you know? So it was just, I hid a lot that I didn't feel good. And I didn't like go to my mom and say, hey mom, I don't feel good. Like I have headaches, I don't want to go to school. Like I just was like, just keep going, you know? But it was something that I loved to do because it was like my time to just kind of get out of my body, because I would go into like a meditative state. Plus you would get like increased circulations and your endorphins and just like all that. And it was just a time that I just felt happy and free and, you know, but then I would get the after effects of like my joints would hurt really bad. Like I started to get bad like hip pains and knee pains and, you know, things like that. And then right before state as a senior, I woke up one morning and I didn't have any ankles. And it was like my kidneys were just shutting down. And that was kind of like a big like, oh my gosh, you know, something is happening. This was such the lowest part of my life, honestly. It was like the hardest 2-3 months I've ever experienced, where I just had to get like so mental. I just had to be like, you will get through this, you know, everything, like we're all given trials. Like you just have to like, what, one day to the next, like breakfast, lunch, dinner, day over, you survived. Like it was just kind of like, you just have to get through this. And like I said in my book, I really feel like that experience of how to gain that mental like fortitude kind of gave me strength in ultra running.
About mile 207. Jesse went dark with some music.
Yeah, I think because I was told so long, like you can't do this, your body's not capable. There got to a point probably when I had my daughter that I was like, or when they found it as well, that I was like, you know what? Like, I'm tired of people telling me what I can and I can't do. And I really live by the Yoga Sutra. It says that when you change your mind, you change everything, because your mind is your biggest inhibitor to what you can and can't do. So when you tell yourself you can't do something, you can't. But when you tell yourself you can, you can. And it's just been really fun to be able to be like, you know, like, yeah, 50 miles. My first ultra was 50 miles and it scared the living crap out of me. And I was like, I don't know if I'm going to survive it. Well, then I survived it. And then I was like, 100 miles. Well, 100 miles scared the crap out of me. And then I survived it. And then I just kept getting, you know, doing more hundreds. And then I was like, you know, now the 240. And is that intimidating? Absolutely. But do something every day that scares you. When you realize that your mind is your biggest inhibitor, then you realize that there really aren't limits, and the only limits that you have are the ones that you inflict on yourself. So once you start clearing away those, like, you know, cobwebs of you can't, and you just be like, let's see what my body really can do, you know, and you break it up into manageable chunks, and you can do it.